Hey people, do you find yourself struggling to find that perfect color pairing for your home? There are tens, if not hundreds of thousands of different color combinations at your disposal. So how do you narrow it down for yourself? Today we're going to talk about the color wheel and how you can use it as a tool to help you with the color selection process. If you want to learn more, good, because class is in session. I'm James from thepaintpeople.com and welcome to Paint School. This is a series where we discuss some of the fundamentals of painting and decorating. Finding the perfect colors is a lot more than just aimlessly picking color swatches at your local paint store. There's an entirely deep and detailed amount of color theory that's involved. And I've teamed up with Nick Talks Design today to go through a pretty compact little summary of how you can use the color wheel to your advantage. Hey Nick.
Hey James.
Nick has a great channel himself, all about design, so I figured he'd be the perfect person to bring along for this one. So the color wheel essentially looks like a circular rainbow that has your primary colors, secondary colors, and everything else in between. While also quite nice to look at, this tool is quite powerful when selecting color schemes within your home. These don't necessarily need to be wall colors only, because you can also use a color wheel to figure out what color your accents within the room will be. I use it all the time, and hopefully after this video, you'll be empowered to use it too. So in regards to color schemes, we're going to talk about three of the most popular ones using the color wheel, as well as some actual paint color examples of each one. The first one being a monochromatic color scheme. Monochromatic by definition means one color. That being said, within a monochromatic color scheme, you're free to use varying shades within that base color hue. For example, if you're looking at red, you can really take your pick from all the different reds along the color chip, whether lighter or darker. But keep in mind, not all color chips are created equal. If you have, let's say, the Off-White collection from Benjamin Moore, it's just an arrangement of all sorts of different colors, so you can't really use that monochromatic rule in this case. Essentially, the colors in this color scheme will have the same hue, but different tones and levels of saturation. This is one of the simplest and safest color schemes to go with, because you don't have to worry about competing undertones, because they'll naturally be quite similar, if not identical. Now, what if you want to change things up a little bit and not just stick to one color hue? You could opt for the analogous color scheme, which sounds scary, at least to me, but it really isn't. In this case, analogous really just means comparable in a way, and that's exactly what we have here with this color scheme. Colors that sit right next to each other on the color wheel will create an analogous color scheme, meaning they'll have similar but not identical hues, but they will share similar characteristics. For example, you could pair a purple and a blue and a teal, and they'll work together in an analogous fashion. It's tough to say. This is a little bit trickier to pull off sometimes than a monochromatic color scheme, but what I find is the closer you stay in the depth or LRV of each color, the easier it'll be to pair them together, especially pastel colors. For our third and final color scheme, we're going to send it over to Nick to talk about complementary colors. Take it away, Nick.
Thanks, James. Okay, so complementary color schemes are kind of intimidating, but also really exciting because they are colors that exist on opposite sides of the color wheel. So this means we are working with all the different tints, tones, and shades of each different color on opposite sides of the wheel. This is exciting for a couple of reasons. First of all, it creates a real contrast and drama in a space that I think is really exciting and can make for a really beautiful space. Also, what it does is it's a great way to combine warm and cool elements in your space. So sometimes when you're working with a monochromatic or an analogous color scheme that James talked about, you're oftentimes working with just either cool or warm elements, but if you want to create a really balanced space, you get that with a complementary color scheme, which I think is really cool. So to really dial in that color palette for a complementary color scheme, I would work with a color wheel tool. I use one from Canva, which I think is really great, and it really sort of locks in, once you select a color, it sort of locks in its complement so that you know your space is going to be cohesive because those colors exist exactly on opposite sides of the wheel. And then from there, of course, you can start to really dial in that color palette and start to bring in different decor pieces, your furniture, your fixed elements, your paint, of course, and you can start to bring those things together knowing it's going to be cohesive because you're working within this color palette. But of course, you also can't forget about those neutrals, because neutrals all have undertones, and you want to make sure that those undertones are working with either side of the color wheel, that they're working with your color palette, they're working with those complements. So a really good example of this would be that if you're maybe creating a blue and an orange color scheme, which are complements because they exist on opposite sides of the color wheel, you might want to avoid using a white paint with significant yellow undertones to it. So James has on his his channel and I have on my channel many different videos on undertones and neutral paints, but don't forget that those neutrals should really work together with the rest of your color palette. Don't be confused into thinking that you can just throw a neutral on the wall and you're good to go. It should work cohesively with the rest of your space. So that's it for me, you guys. Thanks a lot, James.
So with this knowledge of color wheels, I look forward to hearing about some of your awesome color schemes in the comment section below. If you're still having some trouble, you can always seek the advice of a professional color consultant or designer to provide you with some more concrete tips. Nick from Nick Talks Design did a great job at explaining how to pick a trim color in this video right over here. There's a lot of handy information in this video, and it also co-stars me. Thanks again to you, Nick, for joining me in this video, and thanks to all of you for watching the content. We really, really appreciate it at the Paint People. See you on the next one.